JRA 501. I'm back in the Agricultural Defense Coalition, and this is the U.S. Navy tab. And I came in here and talked about what's happening with the marine mammals and how the Navy, the U.S. Navy, and their warfare testing expansion. And here's the map that they're expanding the entire Eastern Seaboard, the Gulf of Mexico, Northern United States, Alaska, Mariana Islands, Hawaii Islands, and down in San Diego. So today I wanted to go into some of the other issues that are going on with the ocean. Let's see. Okay, this is exposure to contaminants and other hazards from military sources. Military is a major source of toxic, occupational, and environmental exposures that can increase cancer risk. Information is available about some military activities that have directly or indirectly exposed military and civilian personnel to carcinogens and contaminated soil and water in numerous locations in the United States and abroad. Nearly 900 Superfund sites are actually abandoned military facilities or facilities that produced materials and products for or otherwise supported by military needs. Some of these sites and the areas surrounding them become heavily contaminated due to improper storage and disposal of or known suspected carcinogens, including solvents, machining oils, metalworking fluids, and metals. In some cases, these contaminants have spread far beyond their points of origin because they have been transported by wind currents or have leached into drinking water supplies. But they get to get away with it. So let's take a look at the oceanic dead zones. And this is from, Scientific American. More bad news for the world. This was articles from 2008. Dead zones, areas of bottom waters too oxygen depleted to support most ocean life. And in this small picture, this is the entire East Coast and the Gulf. This looks exactly like the map that the military is using for their exercises, warfare exercises. There are now 405 identified dead zones worldwide, up to 49 from the 1960s, and the world's largest dead zone remains the Baltic Sea, whose bottom waters now lack oxygen year-round. So let's take a look at the global map. So as you can see here again, predominantly all of the East Coast and the Gulf, and some major spots, again, major spots that are exactly where the military is continuing to do their training with sonar and weapons, and where they go in and bomb old military ships because it's cheaper to do that and have them sink to the bottom of the ocean rather than dismantle them and recycle the metal. They say they try to strip out a lot of the contaminants that are on these big, huge warships, but do they really? Okay, so Now I'm going to go into the Global Conference on Oceans, Climate, and Security. And this is the gulfbase.org. You can go in this and go through all of what the issues are. This is a pretty good site here. It explains really what's going on in the Gulf. And the Global Conference on Oceans, Climate, and Security. I looked that site up, and it's actually the Collaborative Institute for Oceans, Climate, and Security. This is distinguished by its unique focus on the intersections of oceans, climate, and security and the resulting policy and management significance. Founded on the principle that collaborative partnerships have the potential to better address the human and national security threats that will continue to surmount as climate and oceans drastically change. I guess somebody forgot to tell the Navy about it. Multiple threats such as environmental degradation, resource depletion, and political instability heightened by climate change are emerging as national security issues worldwide. With more than a third of the world's population living within 100 miles of a coast, it is essential that the effects of climate change on oceans and humanity be better understood. Through strategic convening, research, and communication efforts, the Collaborative Institute advances solutions to the complex problems, and most people most impacted by are responding to, linked to the ocean, climate, and security challenges, and preparing coastal communities for a safer, more productive, and healthy future. Okay, so let's see about their conference. Global Conference on Oceans, Climate, and Security. So, what I thought was interesting about this site is this background photo. We have scalar skies, and icy waters, ice pack waters, and it's a completely over-pixelated photo. Now, why couldn't they, this is just weird to me. This is just me, but I just think this is weird. Because in the first place, why couldn't they put up a photograph of a really beautiful ocean so that we could have some hope? And I don't understand, because this is the global awareness thing that I just read to you, from the University of Massachusetts, Boston, that's like the United States. So why wouldn't they at least have a picture of, you know, the souring and the killing off of the Gulf Coast? Why this picture? There's some significance to this picture. And I am going to give a plug for Believers Underground and all the work that he has been doing for years and years. If you don't know about him, please go watch him. So this conference will address the current state and future direction of science and policy that is guiding international, national, and local responses to these issues in a discussion-driven conference that addresses the theme collaboration and action to address the impacts of climate-related ocean change on human, national, and international security. Okay. So, the impacts such as ocean acidification and warming, melting polar ice, and sea level rise each pose critical threats to human populations, natural systems, and global security. So why is it that there's been such a big row over the fact that the sea level is rising, the polar ice is melting? Why is it such a big deal that no, it's not happening, and now it's happening, and I don't understand. But in going in on this, I also see this global conference. The predicted effects of climate change over the coming decades include extreme weather events. Now, how do they know this? Including drought, flooding, sea level rise, retreating glaciers, habitat shifts, and increased spread of life-threatening diseases. These conditions have the potential to disrupt societies around the world and force nations to change the way they keep populations safe and secure. Okay, that doesn't make any sense. But, so at the conference, here's some of the news. And lo and behold, I just put out a video with the Secretary of the Navy, Ray Mabus, trying to explain why they are almost going to be $600 billion over budget by next year. And that's not in their total. That is just in regards to the F-35 airplanes that they started building in 2001. Anyway, you can go look at that. So I thought, okay, so he's going to be a keynote speaker. So if he is really serious about trying to help the oceans and the climate and the security, then why is it that we have all of these major dead zones that they're continuing to contaminate? It seems like there's a conflict of interest there because of what he's doing with his warfare training and what this stands for is trying to come up with some solutions. This, again, doesn't make any sense to me. The Honorable Ray Mabus. So, he has made a major commitment to the introduction of renewable energy and new technologies for the Navy, not for us. Not for the populace, just for the Navy. So I don't know. I don't get it. And there's a little bio on him. He's hooked up deep. He's hooked up deep, no pun intended, deep waters. Anyway, just wanted to put this information out there, and we'll go into a little bit more about all this. Thank you, and God bless.